independent, randomized, controlled trials show different outcomes, how do we really know which is closer to the truth? Well, this is where researchers use meta-analyses to help them. A meta-analysis reports on all the studies, both published and unpublished, that have attempted to answer the same question. For our purposes, the question would focus on the evaluation of a particular intervention with a particular sample of participants. For example, cognitive behavioral therapy with anxious children. On this slide, you can see the core characteristics of a meta-analysis. We are going to look at particular meta-analysis to help make each of these characteristics more clear. In this study, the authors were interested in trying to answer the question of how efficacious transdiagnostic CBT is in the remission of child anxiety disorders. I should explain at this point that the term transdiagnostic refers, in this context, to broad or generic cognitive behavioural interventions that are used, regardless of the type of anxiety disorder with which a child presents. In other words, a child with a specific phobia of dogs receives the same cognitive behavioural intervention as a child with social phobia or social anxiety disorder. The authors clearly spell out the inclusion criteria for the meta-analysis. In order to be included, the trial had to be a randomised controlled trial. The sample had to include children and adolescents up to the age of 18. Children and adolescents had to meet criteria for at least one clinically significant anxiety disorder. The trial had to include a non-active control, for instance, a waitlist group, and post-treatment diagnostic data had to be available. The means by which both published and unpublished studies were found is clearly outlined, with 128 trials considered for inclusion. However, only 20 trials were found to be eligible when compared against the inclusion criteria. If we look at the point about methodology, the inclusion criteria tell us that each study included in this meta-analysis had to be an RCT in which one of the conditions involved generic or transdiagnostic CBT and one condition involved an inactive control. The trials had to have diagnostic data prior to and immediately after treatment. The outcomes examined in this meta-analysis included diagnostic data, namely whether children continued to meet criteria for an anxiety diagnosis at post-treatment, withdrawal from treatment, and attrition or dropout over follow-up. The meta-analysis concludes that transdiagnostic CBT is effective in reducing anxiety symptoms in children, with children who received this type of intervention being over 9 times more likely to recover from their anxiety diagnosis at post-treatment compared to children who received an inactive control. Given the stringent inclusion criteria and the fact that 2,099 participants were involved in the 20 trials included in this meta-analysis, we can be fairly confident in the conclusions drawn.